God bless you, loved ones. Welcome to the Word with Chester. Today we'll begin study in the 40th chapter of the book of Genesis. Let me pause to just say thank you for watching this ministry. I know many of you watch on a regular basis, and I do appreciate you so very much. Also, we thank God for our newcomers. I am glad that you're here. Just to let you know exactly what we're doing, we're teaching through the Bible verse by verse and chapter by chapter. We started in the New Testament with the Gospel of St. Matthew and have now taught completely through the New Testament. We finished the Revelation some time ago, and we have embarked and started upon the Old Testament, now in the 40th verse of the book of Genesis. I do appreciate all of you for being here. I ask that you pray for this ministry on a daily basis, that God will get the glory and that He will anoint me for His service. Well, shall we start our study today? I'm going to do quite a bit of reading today, less commentary, because the story itself that we're reading, the story about Joseph and his life, it's intriguing enough just reading it. And I encourage you to take your Bible and read along with us as we study the Word of God. I will give some commentary, but I do trust that you will allow me to read more today so that we can get through this entire chapter. Shall we begin our reading at verse 1 in chapter 40? It reads as this: "And it came to pass after these things, that the butler of the king of Egypt and his baker had offended their lord, the king of Egypt." Verse 2: "And Pharaoh was angry with two of his officers, against the chief of the butler and against the chief of the bakers." Now that's self-explanatory. I don't need to explain. Pharaoh got mad. He was a king, so he threw him in jail. In verse 3, "And he put them in prison in the house of the captain of the guard, and to the prison, the place where Joseph was bound." Well, this thing is going to unfold. Let's get excited about it and let's read. "And the captains of the guard charged Joseph with them, and he served them, and they continued a season in prison." They were in prison for a while together. Let's read on. And they dreamed a dream, both of them, each man his dream in one night, each man according to the interpretation of his dream. The butler and the baker of the king of Egypt, who were bound in the prison. And Joseph came in unto them in the morning and looked upon them, and behold, they were sad. They were sad because of these dreams that they had. And he asked Pharaoh's officers who were with him in the prison of the Lord's house. That's not a capital L, so we're not talking about our Lord and Savior. We're not talking about the Supreme. That small L makes it the Lord of the house, someone down in this realm. Shall we read 7 again? "And he asked Pharaoh's officers who were with him in the prison of the Lord's house, saying, Wherefore look ye so sad today?" In other words, why do you look so sad? Why are you looking the way you look with such a sad countenance? "And they said unto him, We have dreamed a dream, and there is no interpreter of it. And Joseph said unto them, Do not interpretations belong to God? Don't they belong to God?" That's a capital G. Tell me them, I pray thee. Well, can you understand that Joseph is letting them know that the interpretation of dreams belong to God? And so he just entreated them to tell him their dream. Shall we continue reading in verse 9? "And the chief butler told his dream to Joseph, and said to him, In my dream, behold, a vine was before me, and in the vine were three branches, and it was as though it budded, and her blossom sent forth, and the cluster thereof brought forth ripe grapes. In verse 11, "And Pharaoh's cup was in the hand, and I took the grapes and pressed them into Pharaoh's cup, and I gave the cup unto Pharaoh's hand." Shall we continue? Verse 12, "And Joseph said unto him, Thus is the interpretation of it, the three branches are 3 days, yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thine head, high place. And thou shalt deliver Pharaoh's cup into the hand after the former manner when thou was with was his butler. And so the interpretation of this man's dream that he's going to get his job back. Let's just make it plain. He's going to get his job back. He would serve the king again. Let's read in verse 14. But think on me when it shall be well with thee, and show kindness, I pray thee, unto me, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh, and bring me out of this house. Can you understand? Joseph interpreted his dream. And he's letting them know, when you get your job back, when you go back before the king, you mention me. You got to understand, Joseph was in prison unjust. Two times, sold into slavery, then bought by Potiphar. And then because Mrs. Potiphar had a problem, she wanted to lay with him and he wouldn't lay with her, she devised a lie. And here he is back in prison. Now, after interpreting this dream, he's letting this man know, when you get your job back, please remember me. I'm tired of being in here. I'm in here unjust. Remember me and mention me to Pharaoh. Well, let's read in verse 15. And for indeed I was stolen away out of the land of the Hebrews. And here also have I done nothing that they should put me into the dungeon. Can you see Joseph pleading his own cause, talking to somebody, trying to get help? Well, let's read. Continue reading. When the chief butler saw that the interpretation was good, he said unto Joseph, I also was in my dream, and behold, I had three white baskets on my head. And in the uppermost basket, there were all manners of foods for Pharaoh, and the birds did eat them out of the baskets upon my head. Let's continue reading. And Joseph answered and said, this is the interpretation thereof, of the three baskets are 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thy head from off thee, and shall hang thee on a tree, and the birds shall eat the flesh from off of thee. Not a good interpretation for that one, but you got to understand, you tell a dream as a dream, and when it is interpreted, if it's of God, it's going to come to pass. Let's read in verse 20. And it came to pass the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he said, he made a feast unto all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. He brought them in, lifted them up. In verse 20, so many words, brought them up out of the dungeon. Verse 21, and he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again, and he gave the cup unto Pharaoh's hand. Well, just like the dream, Joseph interpreted the dream, he got his job back, and he served Pharaoh again. Let's read 22. And he hanged the chief baker, as Joseph had interpreted to them. Yet did not the chief butler remember Joseph, but forgot him. After all of this, the chief butler got his job back. He did not remember Joseph. He forgot Joseph. But you got to understand, God has a set time to deliver. God has a set time even to get Joseph out of his situation. He has a set time to get you out of your situation. It seems like sometime all hope is lost. Well, the butler forgot to tell what about Joseph to Pharaoh, so that Pharaoh could get him out of there. And here Joseph in the dungeon again, yet in the dungeon, not knowing when he's going to get out of there, but knowing he didn't do anything wrong, know that he was just doing, living his life, and he was caught up into this circumstance. Well, get the picture. Sometimes we're in things and we don't know why we're there, but you have to understand, God is God, and in God's timing, he'll bring you up out of there. Even when it seems like you're forgotten and nobody understands or nobody cares, and you're in a dungeon, you're locked up, and you know you're in there unjustly, remember, God is God, and in God's timing, he will bring you up out of your situation. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. If you would like to contact me for any reason, you can reach me at the Word with Chester Ministries, Post Office Box 200483, San Antonio, Texas, 78220. You can also reach me at my website, www.poemsbychester.com. I also want to remind you that we will be singing at the Grand Hyatt Hotel, 600 Market Street in San Antonio, Texas. That's November, that's this month, November 28th, 29th, and the 30th, with the Texas Gospel Announcers Guild. This will be their 24th anniversary celebration. If you're not busy and you are in the area, please come by and let me know that you're there, and let's have a good time in the Lord. Remember, I love you, my friends. I love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you.